The beloved Prophet, peace be upon him, is the source of all joyous celebration and the greatest thing that we rejoice in our lives. And the biggest joy is in meeting him on the day of resurrection and drinking from his noble hand by his basin, peace be upon him. The Prophet, peace be upon him, used to express joy, and he used to deal with joy in a manner befitting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, "Say, in the bounty of Allah and His mercy, in that let them rejoice. It is better than what they amass." So joy is always connected to the bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to the awareness of Allah's bounty. The Prophet, peace be upon him, rejoiced in many things during his lifetime. He rejoiced when that Jewish boy became a Muslim and died. The Prophet, peace be upon him, cried due to the immense joy that he felt. Then he said, "All praise to Allah who saved him from the hellfire through me." Likewise, the Prophet, peace be upon him, rejoiced in the arrival of some of his companions. He expressed joy when they returned from Khaybar after having been granted victory by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala over the Jewish people. When he saw our master Ja'far and said, "This is Ja'far, he has arrived." Then the Prophet, peace be upon him, stood up before he had a chance to fix his clothes, leaving some part of his body uncovered. He stood up in a hurry, trotting until he embraced our master Ja'far, the son of Abu Talib. Then he said, "I do not know which one I am more delighted about, Khaybar or the arrival of Ja'far." He put the arrival of this noble companion on the same scale as the opening of an entire territory because of the rank that this companion had in the heart of the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him. The Prophet, peace be upon him, rejoiced in what Allah Azza wa Jal blessed him with at his weddings. And he rejoiced in that. Likewise, at the weddings of his daughters, he used to outwardly express joy and make it known that he was joyous. He used to prepare them in a way that was consistent with having humility and good etiquettes with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, he used to hold a wedding feast. However, these things did not take him out of the bounds. Unlike what some people do today when they celebrate, they can lose a sense of their boundaries, forget proper etiquettes and manners. There are many people who during a wedding or his son's wedding, they might say, "That's it, tonight is a night of celebration, tonight is a wedding night." Then he would neglect a lot of his duties. He might even neglect his prayers or maybe other good works. And he might go beyond the boundaries of good manners and principles. And the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, was not like that. There were manners and etiquettes in dealing with joy that became prominent during the lifetime of the Prophet, peace be upon him. Because joy can make a person go outside the limits of good etiquettes and excellence in dealing with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The first of these etiquettes is to ascribe things to Allah. When the Prophet, peace be upon him, saw something that delighted him, he would say, "All praise to Allah. Through him, all good things are completed." And when he rejoiced in something, he would go down to the floor and prostrate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala out of gratitude and thankfulness. Such as when a tribe accepted Islam, he prostrated to Allah. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala lifts an affliction, he would also prostrate to Allah. The prostration of thanks. Therefore, all matters are ascribed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second etiquette is to exhibit your joy and to let it be known. The Prophet, peace be upon him, said, "Announce the wedding and beat on the duf, or beat on the daf," because displaying one's joy inspires happiness, love, and friendship between people. When the Prophet, peace be upon him, sees victory edging closer and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is about to manifest what was due to manifest, he would exhibit his humility and brokenness. On the day of his great joy, the day Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opened Mecca for him, the Prophet, peace be upon him, came in a state of humility and humbleness, dressed in worn out clothes, lowering his head until his face was about to touch the back of his camel, showing humility in the hour of joy. He did not come out with arrogance, nor did he ascribe matters to himself. Rather, he ascribed it all to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, from the etiquettes of joy is to dispatch a harbinger of good news. When the verse concerning the repentance of Ka'b ibn Malik came down, the Prophet, peace be upon him, immediately sent a messenger to give Ka'b the good news. Therefore, dispatching someone with the good news and celebrating at times of joy are all from the traditions of the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him. Doing takbir when seeing something that delights you or at the occurrence of something that brings you joy is part of the traditions of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Such as what he did during the Muslim holidays. He used to do takbir, peace be upon him, and he used to love the display of joy during these holidays. Such that a group of Africans came, beating on the duf and playing in his masjid. Our Lady Aisha tried to see, and the Prophet, peace be upon him, said to her, "Would you like to see, O Aisha?" So he stood up in front of the door, and she stood up behind him and watched from behind. These people playing the drums and celebrating while the Prophet, peace be upon him, stood watching, saying to her, "Is that sufficient for you?" So the Prophet, peace be upon him, used to love the exhibition of joy. One of the nights that the Prophet, peace be upon him, most rejoiced in was in his daughter Fatima giving birth to Al-Hasan and Al-Husayn. That was one of the biggest sources of joy for him, peace be upon him. And he used to express that joy. He used to carry them and he would smell them. He thanked Allah and did aqiqah for them, which is one of his traditions, peace be upon him. We ask Allah to increase our joyous occasions and those of all Muslims. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blesses someone with something that brings him joy, he should connect it to his joy in the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him. And remember that the root of all joy is in meeting Allah and his Messenger, peace be upon him. This will be my greatest joy if I am truthful to the meanings of Allah's saying, "Say, if you love Allah, then follow me and Allah will love you."
معاني قول الله سبحانه وتعالى قل إن كنتم تحبون الله فاتبعوني يحببكم الله.